To put some rules, everything which is forbidden offline is forbidden online. To put some rules, to make sure that everything which is forbidden offline is forbidden online, mm-hmm. and everything which is accepted offline is accepted online.
Mm-hmm.
Simple sentence, simple words, not easy to do, but mandatory to do. They want to organize this space to make sure that competition will allow everyone to be able to innovate and to expand themselves.
That has become a wealth driver. Yeah, that's one of the big things. And you know, so we are talking about regulating data a lot, privacy and so on. So digitization, which has been with us for much longer, is not really the new thing, new kid on the lot. It's the value of data and the concern about the privacy of data and so on. So that's what we are talking about.
When you regulate somehow, you give the people, you know, some keys about what should happen and what shouldn't happen. You give them the rules. And so when they see that there is a rule, that there is regulation, they are wondering why it's happening. And then, you know, it's going to follow by having people saying, okay, if there is regulation, it's because, you know, there is something I shouldn't do. And they are going to ask for this thing that wasn't regulation. So actually, it's the reverse way. It's going to come from the people at the end of the day.
Bengt is saying Europe is late, and the commissioner is saying Europe is doing things and needs to do more. What do you think are the priorities, you know, for European innovation, especially in the tech world?
We have an incredible amount of very interesting things to do next. So we need a frame to do it. But once we have the frame, I really believe that in France in particular, because this is what I can talk about, we have a lot of very, very interesting things to do at the industrial level. We didn't dare, maybe, you know, not enough. But if I take the case of Renault, I mean, I really, really believe that we can transform Renault as a real digital company, right? I mean, today, it's obviously, you know, cars, it's metal, right? But I really believe we can, because there is a lot of data that can be coming from those cars, from the people using the cars, and from all that.
Data is a totally different animal to regulate than, you know, a traditional, because it's a non-rival good, as we call it. It's, you know, who should own it? You know, we can't even put, you know, quantity constraints on data, because data, the value of data has to do with how it's used, and it can be duplicated and so on. So it's a totally different world, at least for an economist to be looking at that. My concern is that when you are entering this totally new business, you have to be flexible. And I don't see the way you see it, Mr. Breton, that somehow the system in Europe is very flexible. It has taken a long time to get there for obvious reasons. I'm not criticizing you, because Europe is a collection of countries. It's not like United States or China, single countries. So there are a lot more challenges in Europe.
And I have a very optimistic view, again, you know, for the French technology there, because, I mean, frankly, today and tomorrow, AI is just about mathematics, right? And we are one of the best best, you know, country in mathematics in general. We can count that with the field medals, you know, that we are getting. But anyway, so I really believe that our engineers, and we talked about education before, you know, and we said that it's not very good, blah, blah, I don't know. Mm. But I mean, what I see actually is that it's pretty good. All the engineers that I see, you know, coming my way, or that I'm hiring, you know, in both sides of the Atlantic, and when they are French engineers, I see that they are very, very good. So I really believe that our education system produces some very good people to do specifically AI.
I've been working quite a bit on the DMA and trying to understand, you know, what's behind it and the theory behind the DMA and so on. And it's clear that the DMA has got some very good components, and has got some aspects, you know, which I find a little bit more iffy. And whether or not it's, and very lots is going to depend on the implementation. Okay, mm-hmm. So I think we are speaking about the regulation of platforms in particular. I think Europe has set up some regulatory framework, but regulatory framework live. I mean, they're not just rules, they have to be managed and so on. And I think that lots of what's going to happen in the next 10 years is going to depend on the way in which we manage those those regulations, and that's going to be a really interesting ride to follow.